very easy to lose control of the cart, okay? You can see that on the steering wheels, every cart is equipped with a lap timer, okay? You don't have to worry about turning it on. When we turn the engine on, it turns on by itself. So I'm just going to turn that one on to demonstrate how it works. When you come off the track, you're going to shut off your engine, okay? There's this little red button at the front of the engine. So right now it's off. You pick it up. Okay, when you come off, you just feel the button. Push down on the outside. Now the engine's going to be off. Okay? Don't get out of your cart with the engine running. It's very easy to step on the throttle cable and turn the cart to tail, okay? So make sure your engine's off before you start to get out of the cart. So once your engine is off, you're able to recall your three best lap times. All you're going to do is press the top right button. All right. All right, so you press the top right button once. Push it once and firmly. There's a huge delay. Press it like 42 times, there's going to be some weird sub menu. Once and firmly wait, it's going to click to this screen with your three best lap times and what lap they occurred on. This allows you to track your progress throughout the event, let you know if you're getting quicker or slower. You don't have to worry about turning the unit off, it'll turn off by itself after a minute. Just get up and walk away, alright? Getting out of the car is the opposite of getting in. You're going to see off the pedals, get on your heels, transfer your hands to the back of the seat. If your car dies, your seat's all the way back, your arms and hands really close to the muffler, so careful where you're putting your hands. Push yourself up, transfer your feet to the seat, and over and out to the left-hand side, okay? There's a lot going on in the car here. You're really going to watch for your steps, okay? There's a brake line here, a throttle cable here. These tie rods are nylon. You can make or bend by stepping on them. So only put your heels on the decal floor tray area of the car, okay? Now that we just about the car a little bit, we're going to move on to a little bit of basic driving technique. Pass to the corners, I'm going to refer to as outside, inside, outside. That's all in the way you approach the turn. So your first outside is the way you want to approach the corner. Use this corner as an example, it's 180 degrees right-hand hairpin. For your first outside, you want to be as wide as possible when you take the turn. It's a right-hand turn, you want to be all the way to the left. The left-hand turn, you want to be all the way to the right, okay? Much like in your road cars, the wider you take a turn, the less you have to turn the wheel, and the more speed you can carry. The same theory applies here, okay? So in this instance, you're going to be on the outside of the track. So basically, that's your first outside. So when you turn in, the point you're aiming for is called the apex of the corner, okay? If you look at the grass on the infield of the corner, on the inside of the turn, it's shaped like a dome. The peak, or the highest point of that, is known as the apex of the corner. That's kind of the point you want to aim for when you turn into the corner, okay? So basically, you want to be near that white line. You have to keep in mind the cart's wider in the back than the front. So if you're all over the white line, your rear tire is going to be in the grass, okay? So on this, at that instance, you're on the inside of the corner, so outside, inside. Once you get to the apex, you're going to accelerate out of the corner and let the car gravitate to the far opposite edge of the track. Outside, inside, outside. It's the straightest, smoothest path to the corner. It's allowing you to carry the most amount of speed and the most amount of traction. Get to the apex, you're 3 to 4 feet away from the white line. You're in what's known as the marble. The marble is dust, dirt, sand, and pieces of old tire. The car's not going to brake as well out there. It's not going to steer as well out there, okay? So it'll be on the race line I just described to have the best results and the most amount of traction in your car, right? If at any point you feel like you're losing control of the car, okay? Another basic driving tip, okay? Braking in a straight line, okay? If you have the wheel turn, you slam on the brake, you don't want to set the car to a little bit of a spin, okay? You want to do all your braking in a straight. So feel straight, off gas, brake, off brake, and then turn into the corner, okay? On the inside of most of the corners are these concrete curves. You can see that on the second turn there, it's like a very shallow. That one you can touch a little bit. Some of the other curves are very steep, okay? If you hit them with your car, you don't want to send the car into a little bit of a spin, okay? You want to try to avoid the curves as much as possible to avoid losing control of the car and spinning out, okay? If at any point you feel like you're losing control of the car, like you're spinning, off the gas, hold your foot on the brake until you come to a complete stop, okay? You can look both ways, see if it's safe to proceed. If it is, then go ahead and do so, okay? If you're facing the wrong way, the key to getting the car turned around, if you just turn the wheel all the way and hit the gas, you're not going to go anywhere because that's not the way a car works. What you have to do is go straight for a little bit, get the car rolling, momentum, okay? If you go straight for like a foot, now the car's starting to roll, then turn the wheel and hit the gas, you should be able to turn around much easier, okay? If you do get stuck, it's fine. Do not get out of your car, okay? Last thing I want is one of you guys get hit by someone else. One of us that something's holding the middle of the cart up and the rear tires aren't on the ground. You're not holding the gas like a minute at full RPM. It's very, very bad for the engine, okay? So I doubt very many of you enjoyed it by jumping your road cars. Put it in neutral and just slam the gas for 30 seconds. The same thing here, okay? Just cut the point. So you hold the gas all the way in the engine. It doesn't make a lot of noise. It's going one, two, three. If you're not going anywhere, just take your foot off the gas. If it gets stuck, you're not going to get out, okay? Take it easy and we will come out and get you with that engine, right? We're going to end off on passing or overtaking, okay? So all your passing should be done on the inside. So right-hand turn, pass on the right. Left-hand turn, pass on the left. Reason being that going on the outside is A, more resistance, and B, you have to go through the marble when you're on the left side traction, okay? If someone's going really, really slow, like less than half your speed, you think it's safer to go on the outside, by all means do so. But if someone's about the same speed as you, you're not really going to outsmart them going around the outside, okay? You're either going to have to back out of it, or lose control of trying to make it happen, okay? What I don't want to see out there is overly aggressive defensive driving. For instance, if someone is on the inside of you, you start turning into them, get on the back out of the pass, that's straight to a black flag, okay? If you're on the inside of someone and you're trying to push them off the track, straight to a black flag, okay? If you are looking behind you and swerving to keep someone behind you, is literally the most ridiculously unsafe thing you can do in a kart, okay? In karting, things happen in an instant. If you're looking behind you and someone spins in front of you, you're going to label them full tilt, okay? If someone's behind you or beside you, you're going to hear the sound of their engine, okay? You can have a quick look, like this, look, and then back, okay? You don't want to be looking away from the front for too much longer, right? Most of these things I just described are either A, end of a crash, or B, end in the black flag, okay? Definitely no point to overly aggressive defensive driving. If someone gets beside you, give them enough room, let them get by, and then tuck back in behind them. You can try to pass them back the next turn, or the turn after that. If they're quicker than you, you can try to follow them to see what they're doing, and maybe increase your own lap time, or decrease your own lap time as well, okay? There's absolutely no benefit to overly aggressive driving. Does anybody have any questions? All right, cool. I'm going to grab the group list right here, and we're going to start off with the group one. If I call your name, do up your suit, and we're going to jump in this middle row of carts here, okay? Yes, sir. Motor off, and then press the top right button. So once the motor is off, you should have pressed it firmly, and once, then let go, and your top two tires are going to come up. No, it's going to flash when you drive by the start-finish line, but don't be looking at your steering wheel when you're about to hit the corner. It's like this. Have a quick look, then back up. All right, guys? Any more questions? Super. We're going to do group one. Shang, Ji-Hin, Leo, Richard, Scott, KK, Jesse, and Ling. So you guys will be in the middle row of cars, okay? Do up your suit. Put your helmet on, okay? So group two, just so you know, will be Kyle, Elan, Younglun, Justin, Jackson, Clarence, Russell, Annan, Allen, and Avini. Alright guys, so did I miss anybody's name? Everyone's accounted for, super. Group one, helmets on, suits on, and you get in the middle of our cart. Group two, you guys can wait behind the fence until group one's done or about to be done. I'll call you guys next, alright? Yes, that was numbered from 1 to 12. One is small, 12 is extra large. The ones that are not numbered are generally extra, extra large, and really big ones, okay? Alright guys, so grab a suitable helmet and hop into a cart. No, we're incorporating that. Alright, group one guys, hop in. We're going to start practice. Touge.
back.